also Christmas.
Candy canes! We'll sing for candy canes!
Hey, Mary.
Hey, what's today?
Well, I want to talk about it's a Connellsville Christmas. Where are you at? I need to come get you so we can talk about all the fun things going on that day.
Oh, you know, that's perfect because I'm in downtown right now by Lyons Square. Would you mind picking me up?
No, I will be there soon. See you soon.
All right, sounds good.
All right, bye-bye.
Oh my God,
candy
there's Mary.
Candy canes, we'll sing for candy canes.
We'll sing.
Candy canes.
We'll sing for candy canes.
Yes, okay.
Hey, Mary.
Hey, oh my
gosh. Love your sign.
Thank you so much.
Come
I will sing for candy canes.
Get
Do you want to sing with me? Oh my gosh, I've been waiting out here all morning.
Hopefully you're not too cold.
Oh, okay, I'm so ready. Let's do this.
Since it's a Connellsville Christmas, you know, the first thing that happens to kick off the Connellsville Christmas is...
Oh my goodness, the breakfast with Santa.
With breakfast with Santa.
Just gets you just ready for the season.
Yes.
Got all your awesome food, you have Santa, it just brings it all together.
But, and then, so who better to ride along with us to talk about Connellsville Christmas is these Santa Claus.
I feel like we're gonna have to get in touch with him and see if he's available. You think he has time for us right now?
We could definitely call him.
All right, let's see. Let's see if he's around. I mean, I know he's really busy right now, but he might be able to take some time for us and have some Christmas magic.
It would be amazing. And I have to tell you that the street credit that you and I are gonna get with our kids to have Santa Claus riding in our vehicle and singing songs and talking is gonna be amazing.
Hello, this is Santa Claus.
Oh my goodness, that's so awesome. It's actually Santa Claus on the phone. That's amazing.
Santa, this is Mary. Sampey, how are you?
Mary, how are you?
Oh my goodness.
It's wonderful to talk to you again.
And you know, Greg Lincoln's with me right now, and we're talking about Connellsville Christmas. I didn't know if you had any chance, had a few minutes for us that we could talk about, you know, the best time of year.
Come by and pick you up and have a fun ride around the city of Connellsville today.
All right, well, I'll tell you what, I can be there in a flash.
Really?
Oh, awesome.
Oh my gosh. Santa! Oh my gosh, I cannot wait to see Santa Claus.
This is so cool. This is so cool.
I'm so excited.
This is gonna be a fun ride.
I'm really shimmering in your truck.
Well, listen, I got like glitter on my face and, you know, this is going to be fun. Yes. All right. Let's go find Santa.
Oh my gosh. How do I get out of here? Okay.
There he is.
So we are here at Murphy Hall. Santa's
Santa's here.
We literally just called him and somehow he got here already.
In a flash. He said
it's
in a
amazing.
Flash. There he is.
And he has one of his elves with him.
This is so awesome.
Santa.
This is amazing.
Get here so fast.
It's amazing.
Amazing.
You were definitely here in the flash.
Oh, Santa.
How are you?
So good
Merry
to see you.
Santa.
Hello, Al.
This is amazing.
Hello.
Thank you
Sarah.
So much for meeting up with us. Hi.
Nice to see you.
She's an elf in training.
Elf in training. Well, you're
really?
Going to get a good training today.
Crash course.
This is her first trip at the big guy.
Awesome.
I'm so
first trip.
I know.
Yes. Amazing.
We are too. So we want to talk about Connellsville Christmas. It's coming up on December 7th. We know that you're going to be here. First of all, thank you so much for taking the time out of your busy, the most busiest time of year for you.
My pleasure.
To be here for Connellsville. And so we were kind of hoping you'd get in the truck with us and drive around, talk about Connellsville Christmas, see what's going to be going on.
Well, before we get in the truck, you know we're going to be here at 8 o'clock.
Yes.
This is Breakfast with Santa coming mm-hmm.
on December 7th.
December 7th.
Yes.
We're going to go until 10 o'clock. And the children are $8 for their, and they're going to adults are 12. The tickets are available.
And all the selfies they can take all with Santa. Actually, I think Jackie Lynn is going to be actually taking real pictures.
Pictures, and people can have a disc of all of the pictures that they take. It's a wonderful event, but it starts right here, and then we have time with the kids. We're going to eat first, and then we're going to have a story time.
And then once everything ends here, they're going to load you up on a fire truck, and we're going to have a parade. Christmas parade, you know, sponsored by the Greater Chamber of Commerce here in Connellsville, and we're actually going to take the parade route with you.
Perfect.
And we got some fun things we want to talk about, and it's cold, so maybe we should go.
Yeah.
In your truck.
Let's get in my truck.
Okay.
All right.
Back, you're so
back at it.
Your truck is really tricked out here, bud.
Isn't this nice?
You know, only the best for Santa.
Yeah.
And his elf.
Yes, of course. Thank you for including me.
Oh my goodness. So we are so excited that you are here, first of all. So what we're going to do is we're going to make some stops along the way and make some people very happy. We have some people waiting at the hotel.
Which is one of the many stops that day for the Connellsville Christmas.
I don't know if there'll be snow, but have a cup of cheer. Holly jolly Christmas.
You know, and I did hear that Santa has a really great singing voice too, so maybe we're going to get him to sing along with us, you know what I mean? So, because I mean, that's even magical to hear Santa Claus sing, because I don't think I've ever heard that before either. Hey, touche, I definitely feel that.
If I don't know the words, I get paid more.
Yes.
Have a holly jolly Christmas. In case you didn't hear. Oh my golly, have a holly jolly Christmas this year.
You know, it's going to be the 10th year for it's a Connellsville Christmas,
really?
Too.
Really? Wow, that is a milestone.
It's amazing how fast time goes by.
I'm sure it's really built up after so many years.
First year we had three kids. In the last 3 years, we've had over 350.
Wow, that is amazing.
Yes, it is.
And it's going to be more this year because we're going to be inside. Don't have to worry about that.
Oh, yes,
right.
Yes, for the Somerset train station. I can't wait to see how they have it all decorated up. They do an amazing job with their lights on the outside of the building.
I'm not going to decorate it just a week of Thanksgiving.
Holly jolly Christmas. I feel so into the Christmas spirit.
Oh, we're going. Hey, listen, Santa, you either go big or go home.
That's how we roll. That is how we roll.
We got some other percussion.
I wanted to get a red carpet and have it roll out of my truck.
Yeah, really, that'd be awesome.
You know, because Santa's feet really should never touch anything but, you know, red velvet.
It's a
do you riding in a one-horse sleigh?
Giddy up, jingle, pick up your feet. Jingle all around
the clock. Mix and mingle and a jingle and a beat.
That's the jingle bell rock.
All right, I see some hotel guests.
Oh my.
They're going to be pretty shocked that,
yes,
that they're going to see Santa Claus today.
I know.
And Olaf in your car.
And listen, you know, I brought Olaf today just because of Frozen Junior happening. Let's do this.
We're at
the Comfort Inn Hotel in Connellsville, and now we're going to go surprise some guests and maybe sing some Christmas carols.
Let's go.
Awesome. Let's do this.
Okay. I'm so excited. You got it, Santa.
Let's do this.
Oh my, they've changed this since last year.
They got a new name. Yep.
That's wonderful.
They're now the Comfort Inn Hotel.
Wow. Isn't it nice?
Comfort Inn, that's wonderful.
It is wonderful for the city. All right. We're here.
Christmas.
The Comfort Inn Hotel here in Connellsville.
This is beautiful.
Merry Christmas.
And look who we brought with us, Santa Claus.
Merry Christmas.
So we are here at the Comfort Inn in Connellsville, and we are joined by not only Mayor Greg Lincoln, but also Santa, his elf, and a bunch of my youth group kids from the Connellsville Catholic community. So thank you guys so much for being here. And since we're talking about Connellsville Christmas, we thought, what better way than to serenade you all with some Christmas carols to get everyone in the holiday spirit?
Yes, let's do this.
You guys want to sing a song?
Dashing through the snow in a one-horse open sleigh,
o'er the fields we go, laughing all the way.
Ha, 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 ha,
about bells ring, making spirits bright. Oh, what it is to ride and sing a sleighing song tonight.
All right.
Jingle bells, jingle bells, jingle all the way. Oh, what fun it is to ride in a one-horse open sleigh.
Hey!
Jingle bells, jingle bells, jingle all the way. Oh, what fun it is to ride in a one-horse open sleigh.
Are we still going?
We'll do the next one.
Jingle bells, who knows the name of the horse?
Is it in
the
there?
Horse?
The horse, it's in there.
Rudolph's brother.
Right? Okay.
What's the name of the horse in the song Jingle Bell?
Bob.
Who said that?
Lean and Link.
Would he say Bob?
Bob. Bells on Bob's tail ring.
Oh, it is Bob. Oh. That was a good trivia question. Yeah. I wish I could skip like you. What a great first stop that was.
That was awesome.
We love the Comfort Inn Hotel.
Yeah, it's really, really beautiful in there.
I think people were surprised to see Santa Claus, so that way we got the shock effect.
Yeah, that was really awesome.
They were really surprised.
Got to sing some great Christmas carols.
Got to meet some kids.
Got to meet some kids, and you know, I Santa, I had already got my coin. You know, I was caught being good. I walk around in my pockets, and somebody says that, you know, I'm not being a nice person. I'm like, well, Santa already says I'm a good person, so there you go.
That's right.
Take that.
And you had to earn that one, too.
I did have to earn it. It's been rough.
It's not easy for you.
Yeah.
We've had a couple staff.
I had a few little stumbles along the way, but, you know, I'm getting back. I'm back to the good list.
Yeah. That's true.
The nice list. So I guess our next stop, we're going to head over to the Connellsville Community Ministries to surprise their employees and patrons, and they are going to be so shocked. So I'm excited for it. So let's head that way.
Let's go. Okay, so we just left the Comfort Inn. It's one of the stops on the cookie tour. So while we're thinking about it, why don't you tell me a little bit, Greg, about the cookie tour while we're on our way to the ministries?
Well, that's one of the nice things that the downtown Connellsville, the Christmas committee had added to bring awareness and help raise a little bit of money for the nonprofits,
mm-hmm.
plus bring people into local businesses, because how it works is that local business sponsors these nonprofits. They set up inside their businesses and sell baked goods. So it really has turned into something. And you know, there's a lot of people like myself. I'm not a baker, so you can basically on December 7th you can come out and buy all your cookies for the Christmas
I like that
season
idea.
That you can put
I
out
like
for your family members and friends and say, look, I mm-hmm. I was sweating it out in my kitchen, and look how wonderful these cookies turned out. And how will they
it's
know?
It's a win-win.
It's a win-win.
Everyone wins.
Because, you know,
I'd
be going to the store and buying the already pre-made cookie dough, sugar cookie dough, and just
so my cookies. How do people find out how to get to the different stops? How do they find out what is a stop on the cookie tour?
So, lost the ball.
We're losing Christmas balls.
So how it is that they have they'll have a map that day anyone that comes to comes into for Connellsville Christmas, they can get a brochure downtown, and on there it'll show the whole day's events, and each place that is a part of the cookie tour, there will be a sign outside that business that says official cookie tour stop.
That's exciting.
So that will be, you know, we always go. There's at least 10 different stops on the cookie tour this year. all over the city, including, of course, the Comfort Inn Hotel. You know, the ministries are going to have somebody there. The community center is going to have something. But it's a wonderful way to not only support our local businesses, but to support local nonprofit organizations that support everything that we do in Connellsville.
So I know everyone's probably dying to know Santa, but do you have a favorite cookie?
All of them.
Just all cookies in general. Just cookies.
That's one of the wonderful thing about the cookie tour is people can buy cookies and have different assortment and variety. Mm-hmm. I love them all.
Yes.
What about the elves? Do you bring back cookies for the elves? Do they eat cookies?
Yes, elves love cookies. Of course.
Oh my goodness. Yes. I'm gonna have to pack some. I never think about the elves. I'm always like, I need to bring out my
elves love cookies.
Okay, so guys, do you have like an official elf, like head baker or head chef?
Well, I'm an elf mom, so I kind of help out wherever I'm needed.
Wow.
So like when in the toy factory or in the kitchen making new cookies, so wherever I'm needed, I'm there.
Wow, that must be a very fun job.
It is fun. It's a lot of work.
Yeah.
It's very rewarding.
But it's also important to know that on Christmas Eve when I'm making the trip, Santa consumes a ton and a half of cookies.
Whoa. A ton and a half?
A ton and a half of cookies.
What?
No wonder you need the whole rest of the year to recover.
Salad,
jeez,
you know?
That is unbelievable. Can you imagine eating a ton and a half of cookies?
No.
You can't.
I'd like to.
Traveling at 3,000 times the speed of sound either.
Yeah, that's what I was going to say. I still can't wrap my head around how you can go all over the world in one night and deliver toys to all these kids in the world. Like,
it's pretty awesome.
Because what are we up to? I mean, it's not all kids, but we're up to what, 6 billion in population in the world now? Is that what we're up to now? That's a lot of toys. It's amazing that elves can make that many toys.
It's amazing the amount of energy it takes to move these toys all over the world.
Yes.
It takes 31 hours.
Cookie energy.
31.
Cookie sugar.
Energy,
pure
yes,
sugar.
Pure sugar.
Okay, so we are here at Connellsville Community Ministries, who do so much for our city. They are the heart and soul of this city in a lot of different ways. So we are going to go with our youth group and Santa and Sarah Elf and Mayor Greg Lincoln, and we're going to go surprise them.
Well, you know, on the day of the Connellsville Christmas, they're going to have a live nativity scene, and it looks like this year it's going to be inside.
That'll be
so much nicer for, because the Appalachian Creativity Center kids, the Project Talent kids, are the ones that actually are the actors in the nativity scene, and they normally freeze it out when it's outside. This is a nice little idea for them to move it inside, because then more people will be able to come into the ministries and see what the ministries is
if they haven't been there.
Yes, it's a wonderful day to take a tour of the building, because I think most people don't realize all the amazing things that they do for the community.
Yeah.
But once you take a tour and you see the building and you see what they do, it really is mind blowing, and it's something that does inspire people to want to get involved and donate and help the ministries in any way they can. So
absolutely, let's go lift some spirits.
Let's go lift some spirits.
That they really work at that place on volunteers.
100%.
Volunteers all the time.
Yeah.
Anybody has any time, they probably want to volunteer there.
Yes, 100%.
It is so rewarding to give back to your community, and especially during this time of year, a lot of people are looking for something. Yeah. This might be the time to bring them in, and then hopefully when they come and see everything and they experience just how fulfilling that is, they're going to continue doing it after the holidays.
100%. Mm-hmm. Yes.
All right, let's go.
Let's do this. I can't bounce like you.
Like a deer, like a reindeer.
Yeah, that's right. That's Santa Claus with us.
I know. No big deal.
He's in our posse now.
That's how cool we are.
That's how cool we roll here in the field.
Crazy street cred. Dashing through the snow in a one-horse open sleigh. O'er the fields we go, laughing all the way. Bells on bobtail ring, making spirits bright. What fun it is to ride and sing a sleighing song tonight. Oh, jingle bells, jingle bells, jingle all the way. Rudolph the red-nosed reindeer, you'll go down in history.
All right.
Thank you, guys.
Good job. Good job. We did discuss on the ride over about the live nativity scene. Where is this going to be at in here?
It's going to be in the window.
On this side over here?
On the big window. And we decided this year to have it on the inside so people can come in and see the live nativity. We're trying to get Santa to come in and do the nativity with the children so we can have Santa and the live nativity.
Mm. He normally does. I know that Santa always likes to come visit the nativity, and he does his the special moment where he kneels down in front of the nativity. So it's exciting.
Project Talent is going to be the children who are doing playing all the characters, and we're having 50% off the entire store that day.
Awesome.
Nice.
So that is going to be a great benefit for anybody who
is. Yes, that's the other thing that's going on, is that our local businesses are doing it's a Connellsville Christmas sale that day.
Absolutely.
I know the restaurants are having special food giveaways with a certain amount of purchase, and so it's just going to be an exciting time to downtown, be out throughout the city, and spend a really fun day in Connellsville.
Mm-hmm.
Yes. We also have, we're going to be on a float. We're going to be on a float, and we're giving out stuffed animals again this year.
Awesome.
Oh, yes.
So you're participating
in the
Chamber of Commerce's Christmas parade, yes, which is wonderful. Thank you for doing that, because I know that you're still hoping that more people have floats this year. I have heard that if people are, there's going to be a handful of floats this year, which is great.
I'm so excited.
Very cool.
Yes, it's just going to be a really wonderful day. We're all going to say a small prayer to God that He gives us wonderful weather like we have today.
Yes.
Are you doing anything else besides a live nativity here in your 50% off sale? Is there any? Cookies and hot cocoa.
Oh. We have to have cookies and hot
wonderful.
Cocoa.
And according to Santa, he on Christmas Eve he's eating a ton and a half of cookies when he makes his trip all around the world delivering toys that night. So it's amazing.
I can't believe he can't gain any weight from all that.
It's really good.
It is truly magical.
I would love that.
Yes.
So that day, the ministries will be open. You said 50% off. So people will come in and they might be able to see the ministries for the very first time and tour your facility as well.
Absolutely. We will always have a tour guide around to show them the basement, where everything comes in, all the processes that we do to get things on the floor. Mm-hmm. We're just really excited to participate like we did last year. And what an event. Connellsville's happening that day.
It's the 10th year, so it's like it seems like the committee has gone all out this year to make sure that every aspect of Christmas is hit on that day. So I'm really gonna be excited to be out and about everywhere, checking everything out. I love that day. It's fun to get the kids out and really just participate. The chamber goes above and beyond for all the treat bags and the all the stuff that Somerset Trust Bank this year that they're going to be doing with the kids' activities and all that inside, which is nice because it could be a very cold day that day. As long as it doesn't rain, we're going to be good.
Yes,
we can deal with the cold.
It's not going to rain.
Mm-hmm.
We're going to announce that.
Yes, we're going to say extra prayers that day that we do not have any rain.
Yes. We also have our tree in the window, and you can fill out a ticket. And it is a Laurel Highlands Christmas tree that we had special elves come in to decorate.
Awesome.
They took on the challenge for me. We have been just so blessed with all the wonderful things that are happening in Connellsville and in the ministry.
Wonderful.
So, yeah.
Well, thank you so much for talking to us.
Thank you for everything you do. We hope we uplifted your spirits today.
Always. For the candy cane.
All right.
Oh, man.
Another great stop here in town.
I'm feeling uplifted. Do you feel uplifted?
I feel uplifted
so much.
Feeling
the Christmas
spirit. So this is where the live nativity scene is going to be set up the day of the Connellsville Christmas. So it's exciting.
This is the Christmas tree they were talking about.
Yeah, this is the tree you can win.
To be raffled off November 25th. Write your name and phone number on a ticket. Place it in the basket at the register. You don't have to be present to win. No purchase necessary. Look at that beautiful tree.
It is a beautiful tree. I'd love to win that tree.
Heck yeah. And it matches my outfit. Look.
It does match your outfit.
Not a gold bling. Man.
That's perfect.
So, we haven't said that the theme there's a theme for it's Connellsville Christmas, and it's a Laurel Highlands Christmas is what the theme
very
is this
cool.
year for Connellsville Christmas.
Very
cool.
Right, just forget because about it. It's the 10th year.
It's the 10th year. Yes. Yes.
Nice.
So all right, Lowell, we're gonna continue on our Christmas journey with Santa Claus and his elf.
Yes. Oh my gosh, it's awesome.
So we know that after the Breakfast with Santa, they're going to go right into the Greater Connellsville Chamber of Commerce's Christmas parade here in the city. It's going to start right here at Murphy Hall on North Pittsburgh Street. So we're just going to drive the route.
Take the route.
And just, you know, talk a little bit more about the day.
Mm-hmm.
One thing I did notice that Somerset Trust is having a gingerbread making contest.
Yeah.
I'm terrible at that. I probably would just eat I normally just eat the candy.
There's no way.
I'm not really a big fan of gingerbread, but I do like all the candy that you put on it to make
yes.
the gingerbread house.
You have to be very creative, intricate, like attention to detail. I mean, but I think it'd be a lot of fun as well. My husband's really into making gingerbread houses. He does like to do it. But then he won't let us like get near it. It's like a caution tape around the gingerbread. And then they have to transport it to the place too.
So basically, how the contest runs is that you have to deliver your gingerbread down to the Somerset Trust Bank building, train station, between December 5th and 6th.
Okay.
The official judging will be on December 7th, which is the day of it's called Christmas. And what they're doing is a little fundraiser, and you purchase tickets to vote for your favorite gingerbread house.
Very nice.
And the judging will be from 10 to 4 that day on the 7th. They're going to have the fan favorite, the most creative. Youth will have an actual category from kindergarten through 12th grade. And whoever gets the most tickets in their bag will win the prizes. And they actually have, the prizes are going to be, valued at like $50 each. So that's nice, you know, put a little time and effort into your gingerbread house and you win $50.
It'd be cool if some people did some Connellsville-inspired gingerbread houses, like a canteen, Connellsville canteen gingerbread
house. That would be really, going over the top, above and beyond.
Yeah, I mean,
because Somerset Trust has been such an asset to this town, that they're going to grow their gingerbread houses from less than 5 to probably almost as many as 20.
Wow, awesome. That's wonderful.
Very good.
That is wonderful.
So we just...
there'll be nice prizes, I understand, as well.
So basically, when we do the parade, it's going to take us down North Pittsburgh Street to Crawford Avenue. We're going to come through town.
Mm-hmm.
The parade is going to end at the Somerset Trust Bank train station, and that's where Santa's going to get off the fire truck.
So magical.
They're going to probably fill him with some very hot chocolate, and the kid has blood flowing and nice and warm from riding on that truck. But once inside, because everything's inside this year, which is a wonderful thing that they decided to do, because it's going to be cold. They are going to have photos taken with Santa Claus for the kids. It's sponsored by Walmart. The Chamber of Commerce is going to be giving out treat bags that they make, that all the businesses in town have donated candy for them to make. You know, so the Chamber, you know, puts a lot of time and effort not only just into the parade, but they do a lot of activities after the parade, which will be inside the building. The kids will be able to do, you know, I don't know if they're gonna do artwork or crafts or whatever, but.
Yeah, it looked like they were gonna do some crafting with the kids. So
yes.
Right after the parade, you could just take a walk down the Somerset Trust, go see Santa, get your tree bag, get some goodies, do a craft. I mean, what better way to kick off the Christmas season than that? I can't really think of anything.
Oh yeah, I mean, yes. I mean, it's a wonderful start of the day. You know, really, you could spend all day with Santa. You could have breakfast with Santa.
Mm-hmm.
Then you could be in the parade with Santa. And then you could hang out with Santa at the train station. And then, I mean, you know, the thing is, this guy is magical because he's going to be everywhere in the city that day.
Yeah.
That's why, you know, we are so fortunate that we have the real Santa that lives here year-round.
Yeah.
And in Connellsville. And you know, everyone else is just his helper because we need enough to get all over the world for kids to go see and give their list to.
Mm-hmm.
Mayor Greg and Mary, I also know that Santa will be there until the last child is seen.
Wonderful.
Wow, that's special.
Might go to 3:30, might go to 4:30, might even go to 6:30.
Well, I'm pretty sure that you're probably going to have adults too, because I mean, I'm probably going to be one of the adults. They're going to want our picture taken. I mean, there's no better picture to be taken.
Santa.
You know, maybe the President of the United States might rank up there a little bit, but I still think Santa's at the top.
Heck yeah.
The most sought out selfie would be with Santa Claus, I think. And one of the, you know, the most favorite, you know, Christmas carols of all time, right? I don't know. That was always the one that always stuck with me when I was a child, was Santa Claus is coming to town.
Yes.
So, I mean, what better song that we could maybe sing with Santa before before he jets back to the North Pole to get rested up for the holiday season?
Yeah.
You feeling that?
He's coming. He's coming to Connellsville.
Yes, Santa Claus is definitely coming to Connellsville. He's here today.
I know.
This is my...
Here we go. It's a good version. Favorite.
Yeah, of course. I mean, nobody sings it better than Bruce Springsteen.
And Santa.
And Santa, of course.
Good two-in-one deal.
Oh. And I hear that this is the Santa Claus's official ringtone, too.
Is that your official ringtone?
It is. I love Bruce Springsteen. Especially
you guys all been good and practicing real hard. Yeah.
All right. It's the Connells of Christmas.
I've been good. Have you been good? I've been trying to be good.
I try every day, you know?
I try
every
day.
Especially if I see Santa, I'm really good.
I know. I'm on my A game today.
You better watch out. You better not cry. You better not pout. I'm telling you why. Santa Claus is coming to town.
There's my husband.
Santa Claus is coming to town. Santa Claus is coming to town.
He's making a
list. Checking it twice. He's gonna find out who's naughty or nice. Santa Claus is coming to town. Santa Claus is coming to town. Santa Claus is coming
to Connellsville.
Yeah.
All right, Santa.
He sees you when you're sleeping. He knows when you're awake. He knows if you've been bad or good. You better be good for goodness sake. You better be good for goodness sake.
That's a bass part.
You better watch out.
You better not cry.
You better not pout. I'm telling you why. Santa Claus is coming to town. Santa Claus is coming to town. Santa Claus is coming to town.
What?
Ooh, saxophone solo.
Yes, it's been a fun time, Santa Claus.
Oh, man, Santa.
We appreciate you all.
Thank you guys so much.
Coming and riding around with us. And
it's like once in a lifetime.
Yes, this is like, I've never had Santa Claus.
Who gets to have Santa in their car?
In my vehicle. So
I'm
going to walk tall today and tell my kids that they wish they were with us today.
Oh, absolutely.
Especially Amelia.
You return the favor, but you just can't ride in the snow.
No.
Oh, man.
Unless you're
this is the next best thing, I have to say.
I feel like
I'm in a sleigh right now.
I mean, yes, this has been an amazing experience. And December 7th is going to be such a wonderful day in Connellsville. And seeing Santa all over the town is going to be such a fun and wonderful thing. And so thank you, Santa.
Thank you, guys. Thank you so much, Sarah
Elf.
Thank you very much.
Bye, Santa. Love you.
Now we're headed to the Connellsville Community Center. Because that's another big stop on the day for the It's a Connellsville Christmas.
Absolutely.
The Fit Fan Studio, which is located in the community center, they have an amazing vendor fair that we're gonna go talk to Ashley about. And this weekend is also Frozen Junior.
I cannot wait. My nieces are in it. They are so excited. And it's just amazing that Seekley can provide that opportunity, that the community center has that theater in order to have that fantastic outlet for the kids. What better way to get excited for the season than Frozen?
So we're here. Yeah. I'm excited to go inside. I'm hoping maybe we'll even get to sneak into the theater and maybe Gail won't know and we'll get to run around.
Sing a little bit. Stuff. All right, let's go.
All right, let's do this.
So we're here at the Community Center building and we are joined by Tara and Ashley and they are part of Tag Event Studio. And tell us a little bit about what you do and what's going to be going on during Connellsville Christmas here.
So in this room, we do different parties. We've done baby showers, birthday parties. We have a birthday party obviously set up right now. But for Christmas in Connellsville, we're getting vendors all out into the hallway. So pretty much all three floors, we have about 15 open spots right now. So we have about 45 paid up, ready to go. Mm-hmm. In this room, we're gonna have food from Clubhouse Pizza. Nice. And on the stage, we are hoping that we can get the Santa pictures on the stage with our giving tree. We are taking donations from different restaurants locally for 25 and up to put on the tree and then raffle that tree off.
Oh, awesome. Very that's nice. Great. That's
and that hopefully will be on the stage.
Yeah, also. They used to do a hall of trees for Connells of Christmas, and they would have, you know, all that you would win the tree itself. Right. So that's great.
That gets people into the theater too. And then we're going to be in that room showing a movie for kids.
Wonderful. Also.
And there'll be crafts and everything. We're hoping to get Liz to
that
do some crafts.
That sounds fun.
Yeah, so there'll be lots, you know, like kid. Very things good. Up here.
Family-friendly activities.
Exactly. The whole community center.
So how does someone, if they want to, since you have spots available, how do they sign up to be a vendor here in the community center?
They can either contact the community center or directly on our Facebook page. Mm-hmm. There should be, and there's a phone number, there's an email.
They're comfortable contacting us.
Yep. So they can do a lot of their local Christmas shopping, get that done. What kind of vendors do you already have set up for that day?
We have tons. the band, for Connellsville High School, they're having their fundraiser they do every year.
Very good.
So that will be here, baked goods. And then we have a few other ladies with baked goods. And
nice.
Then we have a lot of local like crafters, people with doing a large variety of different crafts, really. There's been a lot of different things here. So, and then for LMMs, we have what?
Paparazzi, we have some nails. A lot of the direct sales we're still waiting for.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
They messaged us early, and I think they kind of feel out and see where.
Well, there's so many stops.
Right.
Mm-hmm. Vendors, you know, at the library, here at the community center.
But we're excited because we have a lot of local like talent like coming in with different stuff.
I've been seeing the posts on Facebook about what vendors are coming in, and you know, their crafts are amazing.
Yeah.
Like, I mean, it's like professionally things, you know, if you went to Pittsburgh and went to a craft, you know, vendor show, you're going to get that here in Connellsville. So it's pretty cool to see that. We're excited for the community center to be back. A part of it's a Connells of Christmas, and I'm hoping people will come and see all the amazing things that are going on here, especially coming to see the theater. It's great. This weekend is for Frozen Junior. It's just one of the many shows that are going to start happening at the Porter Theater here, which is great. It's going to bring people into Connellsville. That's a nice thing about it.
Yeah. It's all about, we're trying to fundraise, you know, for the community center and then get people in here, all that. So.
Which I do know that the gym. The project is open today. Is
very
New Year's
good.
Day.
They're
actually
very cool.
In the next week or so, they're going to get the floor. They're going to get the flooring done and get everything ready to go. Because there's so many people that are just another area for the funding source for the building and
we
to
have
come
a
in.
Party waiting.
Well, I know you know there's a women's volleyball league that always was here. They had to stop playing because the floor was too bad, and they're excited to get back into the building. So. The building's going to be alive and bustling once that gym is open because people love to use it. And it's a really great resource we have in the city.
Yeah, exactly. And this is such a really nice space. So people are going to be able to come in. There's going to be food available here. So they're going to be able to see the room and the space
we'll
that you have
fully
for the
decorated,
parties.
Of course.
Yeah. I mean, you guys really go above and beyond. Like you can even tell just for this party that you're having this weekend. I mean, this is really awesome. This is just something that you would see like out of a magazine. And it's right here
I
in Connellsville.
I love the,
Why? Like,
the creativity is great.
We're having a party here for my niece tomorrow. And we're so busy that she's in Frozen Junior. And it was so nice. Just that you guys took care of everything. We didn't have to worry about anything. Right. So why are you going to stress yourself out? Leave it to the professionals.
Yes.
Just let them do it. And it's going to be 100 times better anyway. So, yeah. I mean, we're really excited to have you here. Thank you so much.
So one last question. Since you said the food is being provided by Clubhouse Pizzeria, what's do you have a projected... grand opening date or soft opening for your new move and your new spot downtown?
By the new year.
Wonderful.
That's exciting.
We're very excited for the city. I mean, it's another eatery in our downtown. It's going to be it's another draw for people to come in and have a wonderful meal. I know that you are excited to get your own space. Yeah. And I mean, just driving through every day, I see the amount of work and effort that's been going into it. I cannot wait to see it because we all know it was El Canelo before. So now it's going to be, a wonderful family sit down, pizza and everything else. And I can't wait. I really can't wait to come
We're
in
excited.
And to, you know, frequent your business all the time. But I was our favorite spot every week. You know,
I know. It'll be our new favorite spot.
Yes.
I know.
We're doing a taco pizza in memory of.
Oh,
wonderful.
Man.
That's the El Canelo special. I mean, that's wonderful.
I always refuse to talking pizza, but he said he had to.
I love it so much.
That's awesome.
Zeke, you know, something to remember Carlos, yes, our friend. You know, everybody's friend.
Oh, Carlos.
Well, this was great.
Yes.
You know, we're going to keep moving on our It's a Connellsville Christmas tour, and and we're going to head to the library next. But I thank you all so much for talking to us.
Thanks for everything you do.
And see you on the 7th.
Okay, so Frozen Junior is happening this weekend, and we kind of wanted to go check it out and see what's going on, but it's not open for a while because it's still the middle of the day.
So it says it doesn't open until 6:40, so maybe the doors will magically open for us now at 1 o'clock.
Okay, shh. All right. Make sure, look around. Be my backup.
I don't see Gail
anywhere.
Gail's not here. No security. Door is open.
Okay. Let's go. Let's sneak in.
Yes. All right.
Oh my gosh. Frozen Junior.
Ooh, it's a perfect song.
Oh my gosh.
Okay, can I just say something crazy?
Can I say something crazy?
All my life has been a series of doors in my face. And then suddenly I bump into you.
I've been searching my whole life to find my own place. And maybe it's the party talking or the chocolate fondue.
But with you, I lose my place. And it's not like I've ever known before. Love is an open door. Love is an open door.
I mean, it's crazy.
What?
We finish each other's
sandwiches.
That's what I was gonna say.
I never met someone who thinks so much like me. Jinx again. Our mental synchronization can have but one explanation. You and I are just meant to be.
Something crazy? Will you marry me?
Can I see something even crazier?
Yes!
All right, yes!
Oh my gosh.
So now we can say we were in Frozen Junior.
Yeah.
And now we can head to the Carnegie Library to continue our It's a Connellsville Christmas tour.
Let's go.
We are such wannabes. We're going to submit this to Gail Cuneo so she can put us in our next show. All right, so we just left the Connellsville Community Center. Did an amazing rendition of Love is an Open Door by, Frozen.
On
the Frozen Junior stage.
Yeah.
So I'm waiting to, I'm sure we'll get a call from Gail that
probably.
She definitely wants us to be leads in her next
musical.
She
definitely wants us. It's like not even a question.
I mean, seriously, I feel sorry for everybody else that tries out.
Since we're singing, I think we should put on my favorite Christmas song of all time.
And what is that?
Oh.
Do you just want to start it?
Yeah. You're gonna know it.
Oh, I know this song.
Mm-hmm.
Okay.
I don't want a lot for Christmas. There is just one thing I need.
Go ahead, Mary.
I don't care about those presents underneath the Christmas tree. I just want you for my own. More than you will ever know. Make my wish come true. I got really excited with the runs. Christmas is you.
Here we go. All right.
Calling Santa Claus will make
Well, that was pretty good.
Yeah, I mean, I think that part.
I think Mariah should definitely watch her back.
Oh my gosh, you think she'll see it?
I mean, I don't know. We promise we can get it to her
in front of her
to see it.
I love you so much. I love you.
So, continue talking about the Connellsville of Christmas. The other markets that Christmas markets that we're going to have that day is the Gibson House is going to have they're going to be a part of the cookie tour.
Oh, good.
It looks like maybe the Maruka girls are going to be doing a concert at the Gibson House, which is really nice.
Oh,
they're amazing.
Nice.
They're going to be selling the canteen's 75th anniversary ornaments. They're $20. Of course, it's a fundraiser. It'll go back into the Gibson House.
Mm-hmm.
But they also have got a memorabilia from a gentleman that was at Pearl Harbor.
Wow.
So they actually got the Honolulu Times from the day Pearl Harbor was attacked. Mm. And all these war memorabilia from this family has been donated to the Gibson House. And so on December 7th, the Connellsville Christmas, like I think at 1 o'clock, they're going to have a program to discuss all that at the Gibson House. So the public's invited,
cool.
The family's going to be there. And so it's going to be very interesting since December 7th is... Mm-hmm. Pearl Harbor Day. And so
pretty special.
It's going to be, you know, the perfect time to see all that stuff. So hopefully, you know, the community, the history buffs will want to come out and partake, but it will be at the Gibson House. And then, you know, downtown, next to the canteen is the Appalachian Creativity Center.
So fun to go there.
Love them. All the local artists in our community sell all their wares there. I mean, you can find the most unique gifts anytime, but for Christmas, it's really nice things there. But they actually have escape rooms. And
have you done it?
I've done it before. Yes, we did their Stranger Thing one, and it was amazing. So I'm excited because this one they're doing, of course, three Christmas themed escape rooms. One is Home Alone, one of my favorite all-time Christmas movies. Actually, I was just watching it maybe 2 days ago. I love that movie. It's just such a wonderful, wonderful movie. And then they're doing The Grinch. Everybody knows The Grinch.
The best.
And the last one they're doing is Christmas Krampus. Am I saying that right? Krampus?
That's scary. Scurry.
Yes. It's very scary. Yes. So,
something for everyone.
There's something for everyone. I'm not sure if the Crawford School of Terror is doing any kind of a escape room for Carnival Christmas. I know that they were you know, asked about it, but I don't know. But at time of we release it to us, we don't know for sure.
Oh, okay.
There's, you know, down at the canteen, you can go and see their awesome train display that day.
Oh, yeah.
You know, it's $2 for adults, $1 for children to get in.
Mm-hmm.
The Hobo Club, actually, the community center we were just at, they're going to be open for the Connellsville Christmas. It's from 10 to 4 that day. So, I mean, if you love trains, there's two amazing train displays you can see in the city that day.
Goodness.
Take the kids and be a part of it. Yeah, I mean, we were talking with the women from TAG, and there's other businesses in town that are doing special Christmas specials that day, and once you get the brochures come out that day, when you get them, they're going to be all listed on there where you can go and eat lunch here and get some like free appetizers with the $20 purchase.
Ooh,
like at the kickstand.
Kickstand's my favorite. So is there not also a Christmas light competition for decorating? Is there like a decorating houses?
They actually, well, the city has we do a Christmas home decorating contest. And this year, City Bowling is actually going to be the sponsor of the contest.
Oh, nice.
And they're going to give gift certificates as prizes. But we always get a lot of entries because people really go above and beyond to decorate their homes for Christmas. It's a wonderful, wonderful thing.
Mm-hmm.
But we will open that up in December. Normally, the last day to register will be the week before Christmas.
And okay.
The weekend before Christmas is normally the deadline, and then we'll have judges go out and judge, and then we'll put the signs in the yard, and then people can drive around and see all the beautiful homes in the city that are decorated. And the downtown Believe in Connellsville group has every year has a decorating contest for all of our downtown businesses.
Nice.
So it's fun, and you know, a lot of our businesses go above and beyond. I know, you know, Keedy's normally wins the most Christmas lights.
Yeah.
Because Ethan, I swear, he goes and buys every Christmas light that the Walmart or whoever he gets them sells. And I don't know how he hasn't literally Christmas vacation
burn
out.
Burn a few, yeah.
How Chevy Chase, you know, Clark Griswold, you know, blows out his fuses because he has so many, he shuts down the power grid. That's what kind of look like when you see Keedy's.
I love to see Atkins. They always Atkins, have a gorgeous always display
gorgeous
in their window.
Display, you know, the Creativity Center, and they decorate, and you know, the ministries will be decorated. And it's just nice. You know, one of the really nice displays I always like is the Muse Florist has a wonderful Christmas display every year. And the Aaron's Building, Tuffy's mom, she goes way out with her decorating. And it's old school vintage decorations. So it's just another added bonus for the holidays is that when you come into Connellsville, it's all decorated up.
All right, so tell me a little bit about Light Up Night.
So actually this weekend, the Chamber, which of course is the sponsor of the Christmas lights, one of the many things they do for the city, will be out putting up the 100 Christmas tree lights all through town, main streets of town. Takes efforts, they get all their volunteers come out to do it. Armstrong helps, Dave Penzella helps, you know, of course spearheaded by Dennis Martin. He went above and beyond for these Christmas lights. They raised a lot of money. The Career Center kids are the ones that rewired the lights. And so it's a big deal, and it's a nice addition to the decorations through town to get people into holiday, in a Christmas spirit. But the Light Up Night will be November 30th, which is also Small Business Saturday. It's a big day for all our small business owners. So we're hoping that it's a nice day, weather day, people come out and do their shopping at our stores and restaurants. And at 5 o'clock, the public's gonna be invited to come downtown to our City Hall where Veterans Plaza is. The Connellsville Falcon Band will be there. The Mighty Sound of the Falcon School District will be there playing Christmas carols. We got NHS students from Gable and Connellsville coming to help with the distribution of cotton candy and popcorn and hot chocolate, all being provided by the Chamber. So we're just looking for a fun little time. It's going to be from 5 to 6. 6 o'clock, we're going to probably sing some kind of Christmas carol or drum roll or something, and they'll light the Christmas tree lights. And we're hoping that the tree at City Hall is going to be up and decorated at that point, too.
Perfect.
And Veterans Plaza will be decorated. So everything will be lit up at one time. So it's going to be really nice to have that on the November 30th. So just, we always thankful for the Chamber and all they do and all the volunteers that help with that, and thank them. The band is a big addition this year to that, because the Chamber really wanted to do something just besides flicking a switch and having the lights come on. So it's gonna be a long day for them, because they're doing a scavenger hunt this year for the Small Business Saturday. So they're gonna be busy all day with that, and then have to come down here to get set up for the Light Up Night. So it's gonna be from the 30th to the 7th, it's going to be a really great week in the city.
Yeah.
We have a lot going on, and I'm just, you know, hopeful that the weather is going to cooperate for us, and we're going to have a beautiful, gorgeous day like we do today for people to come in and see the amazingness of the city, all of our businesses, all the nonprofit organizations, and you know, just have a good time with their families.
And how everyone works together. I mean, it's pretty remarkable how there's so many different people, and they all want the same thing. They're all super positive. They all care about everyone seeing the positivity that goes on around here.
It's a Calls of Christmas basically is a Saturday, and there's some there are some activities, I think, on Sunday, the 8th. But, you know, they start planning this in January.
Yeah.
That's the unbelievable part about this, is that they this isn't something that they start in the summer. They start in January to plan this one-day event. Yeah. So there's a lot of planning and work that goes into putting this on for the city and the community. So it's we're, of course, thankful to all of them. And it is. It's a wonderful time to be in Connellsville over the holidays. And I definitely, you know, we invite everyone to come. Come check out Connellsville. See how amazing of a community we are. And Connellsville Christmas just showcases us so much by doing that.
All right, so we're here at the library. It's another one of our stops, talking about Connellsville Christmas, and You're here with Sarah, and
yes.
You look really familiar.
Yes, she definitely looks very familiar.
I don't know what you mean.
I feel like I've seen her
before. I definitely think we have seen her before. I don't know.
Okay. Yeah. All right. Well, thank you for being here.
I'm very happy to be here talking to you.
Yes. So tell us about what's going on at the library at Connellsville Christmas.
There's lots of things going on that day. So much that I couldn't memorize it all. So I have a script here, okay?
Perfect.
Script is good.
On December 7th at 12 to 1:30, there'll be a book chatter book club. They get together and they chat about books. And the Crafty Teens, you should join. Crafty Teens is at 3 to 4:30. And those are both with Miss Julia.
Awesome.
She handles those.
And where at in the library, where does this take
place? You know, it's going to be a busy day.
So they're probably going to find a spot for them to go to?
Yeah, wherever they can cram them, that's where they'll be. And then from 12 to 4, I have two programs going on. One is D&D Club. They meet in the boardroom.
Okay.
And then I'm also starting this new program for ladies, or for anybody, but mostly for ladies, a jewelry making program.
Awesome.
Yeah, so they can come anywhere from 12 to 4 on that day and make jewelry.
That's cool.
As gifts, maybe?
Yeah, I mean, it's perfect time to be making gifts.
Yeah, so then there's an ugly sweater.
Hello.
Christmas contest.
We're in the running.
All right. It goes from December 7th to the 14th. You have to stop in and get your picture taken. And then they'll be made available to vote on Facebook.
Awesome.
Yeah, so that'll be fun. That runs from 15th to the 20th in December, of course. The winner we announce on December 21st. And we'll have more details coming up.
Of course, just follow the Carnegie Library's Facebook page.
That prize is so awesome, we can't even talk about it right now. That's how good it is.
So I do know that normally this room, the auditorium, is completely filled with vendors on the Connellsville Christmas.
Lots of tables. We have one table left.
One table left.
Lots of people are really getting into it.
We might actually have to move up onto the stage.
First come, first serve.
Yes, first come, first serve. Do you know what the vendors are that are coming? Or
there's so many different ones.
So many different ones.
I think there's actually some kids coming too to sell things that they make, which
Wonderful.
Is really cool.
How about food or drink? Is there anything like that going to be for sale at the library?
I imagine so. I don't know if there's facts.
Okay.
Yeah. Helen from downstairs will actually be up here selling things that she makes. She's handy.
Oh, wonderful.
So yeah, it'd be nice. I'm excited.
Yeah, I am too. This is a really great stop. I mean, I'm sad that the cafe is no longer in the building.
Yes,
that was,
we all miss it.
You know,
so
coming in for the peppermint mocha and,
it was
and whatever the friends of the library made for desserts was like just a perfect compliment to the coffee they used to sell here. But that definitely sad to see that's no longer in the library.
Yeah,
but
sad.
It's still a beautiful, gorgeous building. Mm-hmm. I always tell people to come up to see the amazing things that Eileen and everyone here has been doing to keep this library relevant.
It is.
We were just downstairs watching someone. They came in looking for a card catalog, which was pretty neat.
That's awesome.
And they're like, there's no longer. So it means they're new to the library.
Yeah.
They came in to get something. I know they were being helped downstairs. Mm-hmm. But so it's for everyone here.
Yeah.
We saw people going into the computer lab that you all have here. That people can
really
use.
It's really busy
to be on
down
the
there. Like a lot of things going on.
It's always busy, especially kids' programs.
It's a place, yeah.
So is Santa Claus planning on stopping here? Do you know?
I think he is.
Wonderful.
Do you know Santa?
I've met him.
Yeah, I met him.
It's weird.
We were hanging out with him today.
Oh, you were?
He and his elf.
Yeah. That's exciting.
Yeah.
I'm sure it was a good time.
It was the best time. It was like a bucket list.
I wish I could have been there.
You should have been there.
Yeah.
Weird.
Yeah.
Well, thank you, Sarah, for being here. We're very excited about December 7th. Come, see if the crafts, different things going on all day.
Yeah.
Come to the vendor shop. You guys that shop online, you don't need to do that.
It's better to shop online.
All unique gifts.
Yeah.
See it in person. All right, thank you, Sarah.
See you then.
Yeah.
See you on the 7th.
Yes, on the 7th.
Really can't stay.
Really, it's cold outside.
I've got to go away.
Really, it's cold outside.
This evening has been so very nice.
Hold your hands, they're just like
ice. Mother will start to worry.
Your
father will be pacing the floor. So really, I better scurry. Maybe just a half a drink more.
Put some records on while I
the neighbors might think
it's a bad out there.
Say what's in this drink?
No calves to be had out there.
I wish I knew how.
Your eyes are like starlights
to break the spell.
Take your hat, your hair looks swell.
I ought to say no, 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 sir. At least I've got to say that I tried.
What's the sense of hurting my pride?
I really can't stay.
Baby, don't hold out. Baby,
it's cold outside.
Still about my heart.
So awesome. So are we gonna try this candy cane stoplight thing?
Yeah, I think we should try it.
Let's just see if we can get out and see if we can find anybody to give candy canes to.
Okay. Oh, there's some people over there.
All right, wait 1 second. So I don't want to open my door and have it get run over.
Merry Christmas! Hello! Hello! Hi,
all right,
guys.
Candy canes.
Good to see you.
Let me...
Take a couple. Take a few.
Yes. Oh, anybody else?
Joy. How are you today? Merry Christmas.
Hey, Merry Christmas. How you doing?
Okay, so this has been really awesome. I'm trying to take it all in. I'm still like in shock about everything that has happened today. There's been so much. So many blessings. First of all, getting to hang out together, getting to hang out with Santa and his elf.
Yes, yes.
Singing with him, going around and seeing all of the things that are going to be going on during Connellsville Christmas and all the amazing people involved.
Yes.
And getting to pass out candy canes and be in our awesome sweaters.
I mean, I think mine's better than yours.
It is good.
We'll have to see when this goes on social media. Maybe they can vote on
who has the best
ugly sweater on the show. The weather was perfect today.
Mm-hmm.
December 7th is going to be a fantastic day in the city. So many things going on all over town. And you definitely don't want to miss it. You definitely want to come down and be a part of it. The breakfast with Santa's in the morning, the parade's at 11. That's going to be hopefully well attended. We're going to have a lot more floats this year. The chamber is still taking people that want to participate in the parade. You can call their office and sign up for that. But I do thank you, Mary. It was fun hanging out with you today.
Carpool
karaoke.
All of
thing.
Our ideas. Like, it was back and forth. I'm happy to have someone as crazy as me.
Just to see. Now I can't wait to see how it all comes together. But it was a fun day in the city, and I look forward to December 7th.
For sure. Thanks.
Thank you.